Good afternoon. Welcome to
the concession stand is open. It is located on the north end of the end zone on the home side. You can get your coat and drinks and snacks at that location. It is manned by members of the Winton's Music Boosters.
We'll be getting set up for this match between two teams struggling to get on the winning side.
Attention Winton's families and community members, on November 8th, Winton's Schools is requesting voter approval of a new bond issue to build new schools. In Ohio, it's determined that the existing building designs are not up to state school facility standards. Because of this, the state is offered to fund half of the cost to build new schools. This amounts to $49 million that will be invested in our community. Under the plan, two new school buildings would replace the six outdated schools we have today.
We have some great two interesting teams, I think, in terms of what we have is the demographics of these two teams. Both very reflective of a world view in terms of how they, the player representation. We have players on Western Hills who hail from Africa, South America. Similarly, broad representation on Winton Woods. These are kids whose home countries are such that their primary sport of choice is the game of football. So, looking forward to today's match here. Winton Woods looks to be starting out with a 4-4-2, maybe even a 4-3-3 here. It's hard to tell with that middle placement there. Similarly, it looks like Western Hills has a four-back formation, 4-4-2 as well. Referee's counting off the players. And we're about ready to start here for the first 40-minute half of today's game. I had a brief conversation with Coach John Hyatt of Western Hills today. He mentioned to me that he's not had the opportunity to see his boys in action too much in terms of a preseason of any sort. They first opportunity to really coordinate any sort of practice or effort was first day of school. So, eligibility was also somewhat of a challenge. So I think he's grateful today to have what looks to be four or five players on the bench helping out. Greater opportunity for substitution here. Well, Yuri Velasquez takes it to the corner, kicks it out wide. Looks like it's a throw to Winton Woods. Header, nice flick header by number 14. Yuri pressuring the ball there, trying to keep it on that end of the field. One of the other challenges Coach Hyde talked about was a language barrier, that some of his players are not, English is not a primary language, so he's having some of his other players who are multilingual translate his instruction during the flow of play. Smotherman is pressuring ball. Ball over the top to Cameron Mills. Safely snagged there. Distributed long again back out to Yuri Velasquez again. Out once again to Winton Woods. Good finish, nicely done by Jonathan Smotherman. Put Winton Woods on that easy cross. Nice run into the box by number 11. One nil up for the Warriors. Good release up the line for Western Hills, pressuring wide. It's Michael Barwick out to Western Hills. First real opportunity for Western Hills inside the box today, or in the attacking third. Looking to bring it down here, I would think. Chasing it out wide, out to Winton Woods. First real opportunity. That first goal might have charged up Winton Western Hills just a tiny bit to get their efforts together. Once again, snagged by Cameron Mills. Good effort to release out wide for Winton Woods players. Kamal Damal with the ball, keeping it short. Back to Smotherman, nice one touch wide back to number 10, Bola Podol. I like the one touch is shows some confidence on the part of Winton Woods to rely on space, look for those opportunities to maintain possession. Injured player down for Winton, or excuse me, Western Hills. Tell the it's number 6. Dixon Flores. A good ball over the middle. Back down in the box for Western Hills. Out on Winton Woods to give a corner kick for Western Hills. John Smotherman making the calls, looking for folks to mark inside shoulder here. Ball into the about the 8 yard line. Looking to control number 10 for Western Hills. Out of play. Offside call for in Wintwood's favor. Long ball into the attacking third. Good touch wide. Oh, takedown by number one for Western Hills. Outside a foot touch back into the box. That would be a foul. Long ball for out of play. Host of subs for Winton Woods. Nice touch wide. Oh, well done. Good release. Out for a corner. Nice work by the Warriors, bringing that ball through the into the box. Win. Unfortunate release there. Looking to cross. Unfortunately, not as productive as a nice thought in terms of the cross in. Fortunately, off the outside of number 16's foot. Thank you.
possession Warriors. Substitution for Wynn Woods. Into the game, number six, Ramiro Sotelo.
Coach Snell taking some time to talk with Blake on that last exchange there. Ball released to the wide to number 12, Romel Velasquez. Sotelo header in by number seven, Gary Velasquez over. I'm sorry.
Substitution for the Winton Woods Warriors into the game, number 11. John
Michael White
Sutherland.
Number seven today. Good effort bringing the ball down. Still controlled by Romelo Sotelo to 21. It's Juan Garcia. Good first step. Good close of space there. All right, good win back from Western Hills, looking for an opportunity. Still some shape and communication challenges, I think, for Western Hills, but otherwise.
Offsides.
Offside call on Western Hills. Subs waiting to come in for Western Hills. Kamal Damal and Jack Schramm, I believe. Be stepping in just a moment. Good win for Isaac Boating. Oh, nice effort into the box. And a foul. I'm not sure what the call was. I think he's calling a PK for a shove in the box. Who will be taking this kick for the number seven? Bada Gray, I believe, is how that's pronounced. Or Bada Shea, excuse me, Bada Shea. Bada Shea will be taking this for a shove in the box. One-one, Western Hills and Woods.
Called by Adam Sadi. The 24-minute, 36-second mark of the first half.
As I said to the coach Hyatt, my apologies for the mispronunciation of many of the players' names today. Did not receive a primer on that. So we do our best. Right. So Jack Schramm to kick off. It's Bullet Puddle up at the top. Back to Romello Sotelo. First step by Western Hills. Back to nice work by number one for Western Hills. Trying to do way too much on his own. Unfortunately, was not able to get productive. Back up to Jack. Good touch back. And now we created another counter for Winton Woods. Unfortunately, a little bit too strong to the middle third. One touch. One out of the air almost. There we go. Good first touches with purpose. Those are nice to see. And a nice release there. Well done. And can he win it? Nice effort. Good strong run. Good creative long touch for Winton Woods there.
Substitution for Winton Woods in the game. Number four, Blake Perkins.
Nice long ball into the attacking third. A foul on Winton Woods.
Possession Mustangs.
One-on-one effort there. Touch back by Western Hills. One back by John Smitherman. Unfortunately, not kept. Well done. Good distribution again. Creating those one-touch, two-touch opportunities and 2v1 situations. Good to see. Oh, I like that, too. Nice effort. Good foundation there by... Oh! Unfortunate. Good cross. Creating a goal scoring opportunity for number 22. There's Jean Gali. Winwood's doing a nice job man marking. Oh, long release though. And let that number two sneak behind.
Cameron Mills with the stop hand clear for the Warriors.
Number 10. Puddle with the throw. Thank you. Oh. Out of play for a goal kick.
Possession Mustangs.
About 19 minutes left in the first half of play. Keeper for Western Hills. Yeah, for the most part, it's obvious that, you know, the Western Hills team has players who are comfortable with the ball at their feet. Technique is pretty good. Some creative touches individually. It's the collective effort that, you know, where there's the lack of familiarity with the you know, who is going to do what on the field. A lot of, you know, pursuit of the ball, you know, dual pursuit of the ball, lacking that communication and familiarity with coverage. I think that's working in Winton Woods' favor to a great extent. More familiarity, comfort with the ball, comfort with the, especially in the one-touch efforts on the attack. Got a direct kick for Winton Woods. Western Hills is sliding 10 back. Number 7 is still out a bit. Safely collected by the Western Hills keeper. And distributed wide. Unfortunately, not wide enough. Out to Winton Woods. Cleared out by Western Hills. Went back by Bola, Podal. Back to Mike White. Unfortunate touch there. Drew Jackson controlling it in the midfield. Out wide to Berm. Back to Jack. Oh, unfortunate. Looking for that cross again. Long ball in. Good thought.
Western Hills possession. Substitution for the Winton Woods Warriors in the game. Number 12, Romel Vasquez.
Jack Schramm substituted off of Romelo Velasquez. Header, nice strong header. Creating an opportunity out of play. Unfortunately, out of the stadium, too. Just about at the 15-minute mark left in this half. A strong throw, good flick header, and on frame and goal. Nicely struck by number 15, Berm Betambima.
Mark of the first half.
Nicely struck. So Winton Woods taking good advantage of their opportunities, creating the cross, you know, finding ways to put the ball on frame. Good turn by Bima to make and put that ball behind in the back of the net. Junior Ortiz coming in for Bulopodal. And making his way, his presence known in the box immediately. I imagine that wind feels pretty good for the players down there right now. Turf tends to be a little bit toasty. Cleared out by number five for Western Hills.
Possession, Western Hills.
And their throw must have flicked off Winton Woods player. Stick, number 11 there, John Smitherman. Looking for a cross. Poto looking for a cross, unfortunate. Betim Bima is there.
Made by Gabrielle Bach Marshall of Western Hills.
Back across midfield. Cleared out by Junior Ortiz, carried long by Smotherman. Out of play. Mike White carrying into the attacking third. Oh, nicely done. Good ball. Outside of foot, nice progression and unselfish touch there. That was really well done. Fortunately, it was offside. secured by Cameron Mills. Looking to take that ball back up to mid. Oh, nice chest. Pressured by Bola. Podol. Back to Mike White. Won by Western Hills. Secured in by number three, Isaac Boating. Barwick for the kick. Nice. Looking for that broader touch. Well secured. High lofting kick secured by Drew Jackson. Lost again by to Western Hills. A little bit too much creativity there. A little box to box activity here. Western Hills securing it. That's no danger there. Ball carried out. Wide for a goal kick for Winton Woods.
Substitution for the Warriors into the game. Number 14, Kamal Gamal. Number 21, Alan Garcia.
Secured out wide and a nice turn to number 12, Ramel Velasquez. Oh, pushed off the ball. That will be a foul. Complete hip displacement there. Looks like Michael Barwick will be taking this kick as well. Wint Woods will put six in the box for this kick. And it's 2-1. Winton Woods with 7 minutes left in the first half. There was an illegal substitution there that might have been called.
A yellow card.
A yellow card. A yellow card or?
There was a yellow card on the play.
Okay. There was a yellow card evidently on that play, which necessitated the substitution. Another opportunity for Winton Woods. Unfortunate. Let's see what they got. Lepodel still trying to get the possession. Good 1v1 effort with Dixon Flores on the other side of that equation. Back in the box. Had a nice effort by Mike White to put the ball on frame. A header. Back. It's a play on situation there. Out to Winton Woods. Safely secured here by Winton Woods on the through ball. Back to Garcia. Still winning. Good effort maintaining possession. Keeping the ball in bounds. Nicely done on the touchline there to number 10, Bolopoldo. Back to Garcia. Ah. Again, very unselfish play. Header out of bounds to Western Hills. Isaac Boating with the throw. Well done. Good strike by Mike White.
Save by Hawk Marshall of Western Hills. Possession Western Hills.
A little bit of an opportunity here for Western Hills. Do not have the numbers up, though, to create a workable opportunity at this point. We got some folks making runs into the box. Surrendered. Dangerous play. Leading to a indirect kick. Alan Garcia brought that down quickly. Back to Velasquez. Back to Blake. Or Drew Jackson, I'm sorry. Secures ball, sends it up. Good release. Garcia will look for the cross. Might have even had an angle on frame. Chest by Isaac Boating. Secured wide. Oh, through the box. Picked up by Bach Marshall. Release to Holmes. Looking for the long ball to number one for Western Hills. Back. Cameron Mills calling for the ball. Secured. Looking to distribute.
1 minute to play in the first half. 1 minute.
Wide. Fortunately, Blake couldn't chase that one down. Holmes for the throw. Secured by Western Hills. Looking for, again, a little short of numbers. If they want to make this run, they have to have a little bit better shape and attack on that. They get this close. There's a little bit better structure here now for Western Hills. One wide by Michael Barwick. Nice, nice. There's a 10-second countdown. The end of the first half.
Four, three, two, one. That's the end of the first half.
at the end of the first half. It's Wentwood's Warriors 2, the Western Hills Mustangs 1.
This is what matters. This is beyond X's and O's. This is the difference mutual respect makes. This is what character looks like. This is what defines us in Ohio. This is sportsmanship. School sports, it's not the outcome that matters most, but the way the games are played. This message presented by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Ohio Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
Hi, I'm Bob Hoying. The life lessons that interscholastic athletics can teach kids are so much more important than wins and losses, and will stay with them long after their playing days are over. Discipline, teamwork, sportsmanship, integrity, getting along with others, and overcoming adversity can all be learned through school sports. The lessons that these student athletes learn through sports today will help them be prepared for wins and losses of life tomorrow.
This message presented by the Ohio High School Athletic Association.
Hello and welcome back to the Winton Woods Warriors versus the Western Hills Mustangs men's soccer game from Charles Frederick Field on the campus of Winton Woods High School in Forest Park, Ohio. We'll get back to the action here in just a moment. The situation is we have the Warriors up 2-1 over Western Hills, switching sides, switching ends of fields. Very fairly balanced game. Very balanced game to this point. I think what distinguishes the two teams thus far is just a little bit more continuity on the part of Winton Woods in terms of possession and attack. Western Hills has some good technique. Has a little bit of a challenge with respect to just holding possession and communication seems to be a little bit of a challenge as well. Communication in terms of, you know, placement on the field, technique on the field. Nice quick strike by Winton Woods. Stopped by Gabriel Bach Marshall, the keeper for Western Hills. First shot on goal for the second half. Quick distribution to Western Hills. Nice ball wide. So I mentioned earlier that Western Hills lost to Deer Park 3-0. Winton Woods came off a 5-5 tie to Finneytown. A lot of goals scored in that one. Both teams, again, looking for their first win of the season. Good pressure by Mike White. Unfortunately, still one. Nice turn by Yuri Velasquez. I'm sorry, that's Rommel Velasquez. One by Western Hills. One back by Winton Woods to Smotherman. Michael Barwick, one wins that out of the air. Gives it up. Yeah. released wide by and carried wide, unfortunately. Oh, that's a foul. No foul there, but or no card there, but it was definitely a takedown, unfortunately. A kick to Western Hills. Shea is going to take this kick, I believe. That's number 7. Oh, I think they'll have to do a re-kick. Looking for a ball inside the frame, and it looks like that is I'm not sure what the call was. It looked like some sort of. We can look at the replay here and see what the story is. All I can think is there may have been a shove of some variety inside the box. Oh, yeah, okay. There's going to be a consultation on the part of the assistant referee and the referee to see what the call was. So there may have been some discrepancy in the call. I think the center ref saw a shove that resulted in one of the Western Hills players sprawled on the inside the 18. I think they're going to allow that to go. So 2-1 still. No PK for Western Hills, and instead just a kick for Winton Woods. Another foul against Western Hills. Well, still trying to pressure ball. One by 22. Nurjan Ghali back to Bola. Got a ball on frame. Easily snagged by Bach Marshall. Released upfield. A little shove in the back by number 3, Isaac Boding. Creating a direct kick situation. A little number shy. Well defended by Winton Woods. Still looking for the opportunity to carry wide. Here we go. Michael Barwick doing a nice effort carrying out. Back to Nurjan Ghali. Jack Schramm looking to control and carry up the right flank out on Western Hills. Berm Bentimbina back in the game. Our goal scorer from the first half today's game. One of our goal scorers, I should say, for Winton Woods. Out of play, Winton Woods throw. Yuri Velasquez in for Jack Schramm. Coming up after today's match on the 8th, 2 days, a quick turn, Deer Park. Winton Woods goes to Deer Park for a game. Flick header. Offside. Flag is up. Unfortunate. But the replay shows that I think it was right there. Yep. Just a little bit offside on that touch after the final defender. Cadence of whistles this second half is a little bit quicker than the first half. So Michael Barwick looking to put a ball inside the 18, and we got a header. Oh my goodness, what a shot. What an effort. Nice header effort. I think that was... Is there a replay on that? Here we go. Okay. Deer Park is a common opponent of these two teams. As mentioned earlier, Deer Park lost, or Western Hills lost to Deer Park 3-0 on the first. And their common opponents include Finneytown. Finneytown beat Western Hills on the 25th of August, 3-2. As mentioned earlier, Finneytown tied Winton Woods 5-5 this past weekend. Gary Velasquez tempted to bring it through. Numbers up, situation for Winton Woods, easily cleared out wide. Unfortunately, not able to be maintained. Western is looking to cross, easily snagged by Cameron Mills.
Cameron Mills with the stop and clear for the Warriors.
Toss wide to Mike White. Momentarily dispossessed, but won it back. Now looking to carry to the middle third. Bullapodal. Nice, easy. Unfortunate. A little bit too long. Mike asking for it to be a little bit further in front of him. Long ball to Brian Morales. Back to number 10. Cleared out again by Winton Woods. Drew Jackson carrying that out to Michael White. Bullock attempting to win it as well. Out to touch. A little shoving, a little issue with the bench there. So it went in, Western Hills. A little discontent there. Might incur the wrath of the referee if that continues. He's giving him a kick. That must have been a... Header flick to the keeper. Not very dangerous at all, but secured. Isaac Bodine up to Ray Velasquez. Pressured by looking to cross. Nice ball into the cross. Unfortunately, a little bit too long to Mike White on the cross from Gary Velasquez. A couple substitutions. Shot on frame, easily handled by Gabriel Bach Marshall. Distribute quickly to number seven. Carey looking for options, has options. Cameron Mills steps up though, easily snags it. Distributed wide to Betembina. Here Velasquez, I'm not sure. Handling is the call. Handling is the call. Right there, perhaps. Quick touch, hard to capture in that replay. Opportunity missed, unfortunately, for Winton Woods. Out of play to Winton Woods. Bola trying to secure, take long. Nice ball, looking for the cross. Secured, brought down. Well done, a nice strike. Long, quick touch out, kick out. Controlled by Western Hills. Turned to no one in particular, won by Winton Woods. Still on, Bola to Yuri. I think it's a play on situation. Nice effort though. Clean play. Nicely done by Garcia. Controlling possession. Creating, and again, little extracurricular there that I think the referee has seen. Is going to card Alan Garcia for the reaction there to a scrum as they went down the field, unfortunately. Here's the play that both players going for the ball. Hard to see anything in that replay that would cause any. Yeah, I think it's always the second shove that always gets people in trouble. So the yellow carded player has come off the field. Out to Winton Woods. Coach now encouraging his players to take a wide stance. Encouraging number 15 to Betembina to not crunch in, create some space on possession. Sure if the call was for a dangerous kick or dangerous play. Didn't look like that was the call. I don't know what the exact call was there. It was an indirect, so it may have been dangerous play. Smacked out by Bach Marshall. Put back into the attacking third. One out by number five. Michael Barwick carries it wide to Velasquez, unfortunately, on frame, but behind, near frame, I should say. We're waiting for a substitution. That call was Jack Schramm coming in for Kamal Damal. I'm sorry, Smotherman. I think I said Schramm. Smotherman coming in for Kamal Damal. Throw for Western Hills. Still in the attack as Winton Woods trying to seal it in. Schramm trying to hold him. Continued possession for Winton Woods. Nice 1-2. Easily secured by Western Hills. Drew Jackson secures the kick out of the air and shove from behind by number 6 for Western Hills. For a direct kick, I believe. Little guidance provided by the referee again. We're 21 minutes into today's second half. Smotherman controls. Distributes wide to Sotelo. Ah, unfortunate. Good thought. I'm going to do that one again. I guess that was not a legal throw. Yep. Still, we'll see that call at this level. At times, for better or worse. Obviously, something to work on for Coach Hyatt. Both teams are trying to find that opportunity to string together a good, strong possession. Winton Woods has the, certainly has the piece parts and is showing some innovation, some creativity. And Western Hills just has not had the opportunity to work together as a team. A lot of individuals comfortable with their technique, but the, oh, nice strike. Wow. Nice strike by Yuri Velasquez, I believe. Yes. That would have been a, for his, something worthwhile to replay on his Twitter feed. Instagram probably is what I would think, maybe. I...
Substitution for Winton Woods in the game, number 21, Alan Garcia.
one of those multiple social media platforms. Vine, I think it would be a Vine. Vine, Instagram, or Twitter. Yeah, it could have been a six-second Vine, yes. Offside. Gets you every time on that. The 1-2 on the sideline there. Nice header to distribute wide to Michael White, to Garcia. Sotelo unfortunately lost possession. Here we're back to number six for Western Hills, controlling it. One back by Smotherman. Michael White, a nice ball on frame again. Well done. I think Coach Snell probably is enjoying those opportunities, looking for probably one more. One more at this point in the game. But they're getting their opportunities, that's for sure. Garcia taking the ball. And I'm sorry. Gully. Taking the ball wide for a throw for Winton Woods. Oh, there we go. Oh, good effort by Buck Marshall to just take care of that deflection ever so slightly. Oh, wow, that was so close.
Number 10, Ola Pudel. Number 17, Jack Schramm.
Corner kick. Looking for the header. Oh, again. Good effort. Mike White. Nice effort again, getting height. They're have that programmed in as part of their routine for set play practice on the training ground. So nice run into the box. Putting the ball probably at about the 8 or 9 yard line. Smotherman up to Velasquez. Bulla looking to bring that down, secured by Buck Marshall again. Actually, he doesn't have a lot of targets at this point. We have some gassed Western Hills players. See some folks grabbing their shorts. Yep. Secures wide to unfortunately unable to make that touch. There's Jack making a run into the box, unfortunately just not able to get his foot on the ball. Cleared out wide. Corner kick for Winton Woods. Got a ball right there onto the six this time. I think there was a out of play. Go goal kick for Western Hills. Wide distribution for Western Hills, controlled by number 11. Just too many defenders down there. The 2v1 easily won by Winton Woods. Velasquez putting the ball up for Schramm. Touched out by Western Hills. Yuri again with the ball, looking for an opportunity. Smotherman now on frame, and a ball on the, off the woodwork. Wow. 21. Oh, that was a nice strike. Well done. Alan Garcia from outside the, probably at the, well done. Nice strike with 12 minutes left. Nice work by our camera person. Ball back out to Alan Garcia. Controls it and literally just underneath his feet is able to put it on frame. Brilliant strike. Three to one, Winton Woods Warriors over Western Hills. Good distribution by Winton Woods. Looking to secure yet another one here, looks like. Let's see what the call was here. The players, Western Hills players, playing the player versus the ball, and so we got a card. Will have to be substituted out here. There's some discussion as to who's going to be taking this kick, and as well as what is the exact call. Penalty should have been in the box. It should be, I would think it would be a PK, but perhaps not. Do we have a... see what the call is here, because this would not be a ball inside the box for, see what he will be doing. Interesting. I'm not, yeah, I'm missing. He's calling an indirect kick, so that was why it was in it. There we go. I thought it was a shove, anything with a, and it was pushing, but it was obstruction, so I think it was an indirect kick.
Substitution into the game, number 13, Junior Ortiz. And going in the goal, Blake Cotton.
Oh, we have a new keeper for Winton Woods as well, Blake Cotton. Woods putting the pedal to the floor here, trying to get one more. Leveraging the old adage, there's two goal lead is the most unsafe lead in soccer. So I think they're trying to get one more here to put this away. Western Hills is going to have something to say about that. Still in, taken wide by Drew Jackson. Further wide, let's see who's going to come further wide. Yes, to Isaac Boating. Going to carry up. Brian Morales secures, distributes wide to number 11. He's going to take the ball. Blake stepping up nicely to secure that. Unfortunately. Yep, a little frustration on the part of number one. Was it number one for Western Hills? Made that long run.
Possession, Winton Woods.
Offside against Winton Woods. Jack Schramm, unfortunately, a little bit of an offside position right there. So again, 3-1 on goals by Smotherman, Betimbina, and Garcia for Winton Woods. A 16-minute goal for Badache on a PK for Western Hills. And that's our scoring to this point in this game. Numbers are good. Western Hills puts the ball back into the attacking third. Cleared out by number 12, Romel Velasquez, to Michael White, who continues to battle with number 8 for Western Hills, who wins that battle momentarily. Morales tries to secure out wide. Michael White again. Looking to chip the number 8. Get the ball over to upfield. Kamal Damal coming onto the field. Garcia stepping off.
Substitution for Winston Woods in the game. Number 14, Kamal Damal.
Perkins on the right-hand side there. Picking the ball out.
Substitution for the Warriors. The
substitution, another substitution, 22. Virgin Gali coming off. Or coming on, excuse me. Smotherman to Michael White. Nice thought to create a through ball. White has it at his feet again, looking to secure and go on the attack. Blake throws it in to number 2, Michael Barwick. Again, out on Winton Woods. This is Western Hills' throw. 6 minutes, 15 seconds left in the the game. Secured by Kamal. Another through ball to number 7, Michael White, out to corner. A corner kick for Winton Woods. Deepak Baral is coming in for Jack Schramm. Oh my goodness. Yeah, a little bit of a shove there. Easily secured by Buck Marshall. Buck Marshall has the ability to change possession, directional possession quickly with his kicks. I think if there's a, he can sustain that in some fashion and selectively deploy those kicks, there may be some opportunity for Western Hills to create some numbers up situations with his ability to send the ball long. Number 9 for Western Hills. Michael White again securing ball. I think a foul on number 12 for, let's see. That's right, here we go, right there. Unfortunately stepped in playing the player versus the ball. No advantage for Winton Woods, therefore we're gonna get a kick here for Michael White. Chips up and in, and nice, oh, nicely struck. Easily controlled. Nice controlled touch by Michael White. Created that opportunity, secured by Bach Marshall. Again, you know, the ability for Western Hills to progress in with an organized approach. They have the piece parts. They certainly have the piece parts. I think Coach Hyatt continues to be challenged a bit by the fluid nature of his lineup. And that's worked to Winton Woods' advantage. Coach Snell has some continuity. The flow of play is much more in Winton Woods' advantage. Possession, creativity, a little bit of an right off the noggin for number 7, Michael White. Seems to be shaking it off. Isaac Boating securing it long, and of course, Michael has recovered nicely with a nice ball from about 30 out. There we go. Ouch. Just shaking that one off. He looks a little still a bit dazed there in the midfield. Ramel Velasquez. I apologize now. I think I've called Ramel Yuri through most of the game. Corner kick for Western Hills. I think this might be their second or third of the game. It's a nice ball in, cleared out wide to Winton Woods. Headed out, back down to Blake Cotton for goal. Goal kick.
Possession Warriors.
So Yuri Velasquez going to take the kick here.
1 minute to play in the game. 1 minute.
Out on Western Hills. 3-0 quickly to Michael Barwick, carrying the ball across the middle, unfortunately. All right, with about 20 seconds left, we'll hear the 10-second countdown here in just a moment from That's it. Wintwood's Warriors defeat the Western Hills Mustangs 3-1. Thanks a lot for watching today's game, and thanks to the volunteers and